Hello, Out Late But Great audience. Michelle has asked me to talk about this week's topic, which is boxes. You know, boxes, pigeonholes, you know, where you have check boxes to check one or the other, male or female, gay or straight, married, single, divorced, whatever. Your choices are limited by what someone else thinks that you should be. Now, myself, I have been recently frustrated by check boxes because I went through a bankruptcy recently. Now, for purposes of the bankruptcy, I am either single or married, and when I am single, I am allowed a certain amount of money to keep for myself, and if I'm married, I'm not allowed to keep as much money for myself, and I have to pay more to the bankruptcy trustees because presumably my spouse is helping out with paying for things. So it makes a big difference to the government or to official people what you fall under. So the trouble is with a lot of people in the LGBTQ community is you can't just choose one or the other. Like, for example, there are trans people. Can they choose male or female? The lines are blurry. They're somewhere in between. They're not completely male or completely female. They might be going from one extreme to the other or whatever. So, what do you check? Both? Same thing with gay or straight. If you're gay, you choose one. If you're straight, you choose the other. But what about people like me who fall somewhere closer to the middle, being bisexual? What do you choose? Do you say, you know, gay or straight? It's confusing. What do you answer? And what answer is right? I mean, a lot of answers are, a lot of laws were made for the convenience, such as, let's say, well, it would not be right for a man and a woman to live together outside of wedlock. So they came up with this institution called common law marriage, where if you can't get a minister or a judge to marry you and you want to live together as man and wife, you can do so. Just stay living in the same house for 6 months together, and you are considered married by law. So that it's not an untoward thing. You're not living in sin. Now we're getting into religion again. Religion, who cares, really? I mean, in today's day and age, it's passé, it's run its course. It was a system for controlling people once upon a time by the few who wanted to control the many, but we won't get into that. I have this other scenario when it comes to marriage. It's really good. See, what if, besides being bisexual as I am, I was also polyamorous, and on top of my girlfriend, I would have a boyfriend as well, and we would all live together in the same house. Would that make my common law wife married to me and my common law husband also? Would I be married to both a man and a woman at the same time? Would it work that way? I mean, with gay marriage, if you have gay marriage, then wouldn't common law apply also? Think about it. Could be quite a can of worms legally. I actually don't want to be married. I don't want to. I pay fewer taxes if I'm on my own. I'm in a lower tax bracket if I'm single. Don't have to combine my taxes with somebody else and file jointly and together. I like to keep my stuff separate from hers. I mean, we sleep in separate bedrooms even. okay, we do have physical intimacy, and sometimes we sleep together, but for the most part, we sleep apart. So, why should I consider myself married? Even though the law says I am, because we've lived together for more than 6 months, blah, 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 blah. I know a lot of people in the LGBTQ community are fighting for the right to marry members of the same sex. That's fine. I have nothing against that. You all do whatever you want. It's all good. Myself, I choose not to be married, because I have seen marriage mess up enough good relationships. I like my relationship the way it is. I don't want to get it messed up. Anyway, I want to thank Michelle once again for allowing me the opportunity to talk on this very interesting topic with you all on Out Late But Great today. Goodbye.